Thank you, gentlemen, and welcome to COG Africa, State of Nyanza Region, a press release. This is a follow-up to the State of the Mountain release that we did 2 weeks ago in Nyeri. And we are doing a series of State of Nation surveys, and this time we are in Nyanza Region. So to begin, COG is an acronym for Consortium of Researchers on Governance. It's a collection of organizations, data collectors, communicators, researchers, and our aim is to basically empower and give information to the public. So today, State of Nyanza Popularity and Approval Survey. By introduction, we conducted the Public Policy and Governance Research Survey in Nyanza region between the 6th and 14th of April, and the aim was to track the elected leaders' popularity and approval ratings with respect to implementation of their 2022 campaign promises and manifestos. On sampling and methodology, we applied a stratified multi-stage sampling where the ward was the primary sampling unit. The respondents were distributed proportionally to the number of registered voters in the ward. In Nyanza, the 6 counties, we have 42 constituencies, and we used the IBC 2022 voters register. There was a total of 3,500 respondents which were targeted. 3,310 were contacted, and 3,018 were interviewed, with male 52.4% and female 47.6%. As for the demographics, we are going to see the breakdown at the end of the survey. The sample size had a 95% confidence level and a 2.6% margin of error. On data collection, the data was quantitatively collected face-to-face and also using CATI. CATI is computer-assisted telephone interviews. And as COG, we have our app called COG Analytica, which operates on open data kit, which we use to collect this data. There are also focus group discussions, because there were some questions that needed some in-depth information. The interview language, because of the region, was a mix of English, Swahili, Luo, Kisi, and Kuria. For analysis, the data was collected, analyzed, and visualized in SPSS and Microsoft Power BI. Those are ethical. All respondents were informed of the intent and requirement of the survey and agreed without any perceived pressure or inducement. All participants were guaranteed their right to refuse to engage or to withdraw from this survey at any time. And as you'll see in some of the questions, they were undecided and there was also no response, because every respondent had the right to answer the question that they can and also refuse to engage in any that they didn't feel comfortable in answering. Now to start, we started with the governor, the State of Nyanza Region Governor's approval. And the question was, are you aware of your governor's implementation of their campaign promises and manifestos? If yes, do you approve? They were rated out of 100. And at number one was Gladys Wanga of Homabay County at 68.3%. She was followed by Ochila Yako of Migori County at 61.1%, and closely followed by Simba Rati, Governor Simba Rati of Kisii County at 60.9%. At number four was Kisumu Governor Anyang' Nyong'o at 59.4%. There was number five was James Orengo of Siaya County at 55.4%. Then last was Amos Nyaribo of Nyamira County at 48.2%. And just to touch on some of the issues that the respondent gave, because there was a follow-up question on why, you find that for Homabay County, the issue of when she got into office, she finished a lot of the projects that were left unfinished by the previous governors. For Ochila Yako, there is the issue of the ECDs and the markets in Migori. Simba Rati, there was when he got into office, there was mention of fighting the ghost workers, his support for sports, road network in Kisii. Anyang Nyong'o is a second term governor, so his record is public. For James Orengo, there was a bit of despair by the respondent, and none seemed to point out exactly what he's doing, even though he may be doing something. For Amos Nyaribo, the respondents were, there was nothing that they could point, that they could say, except for a few mentions of Maram Roads within Nyamira County. The next question, and this we added for the State of the Mountain, we didn't do for the deputy governors, but we felt it's important because they are a team, to also see the feelings of the respondent. And the question was, are you aware of your deputy governor's joint implementation of their campaign promises and manifestos? If yes, do you approve? At number one was Oyugi Magwanga, Homa Bay County, at 71.8%, followed by Kisumu DG, Matthew Owili, at 64.2%, then Joseph Mahiri, Migori County, at 61%. Then there was Siaya County DG, William Oduor, at 56.9%. There was James Gesami, Nyamira County, at 54.8%. As for Kisii County, because by the time we were doing this, Kisii had a change in the DG, so it would have been unfair to judge him having been only a few days in office. So Elijah Obebo was not basically surveyed. Then, on the question of senators, the question was, are you aware of your senator's county oversight and national representation undertakings? If yes, do you approve? At number one was Richard Onyonka of Kisii County at 65.1%. There was Okong Omogeni of Nyamira County at 59.8%. Then Moses Kajwang, Homa Bay County, 57.6%. At number four was Eddie Okech. The difference between Moses Kajwang and Eddie was 0.2%. Eddie was 57.3%. Then Tom Ojienda of Kisumu County at 48.4%. And last was Oburu Odinga of Siaya County at 43.6%. The next survey was on the women rep approval. And the question was, are you aware of your county women rep affirmative projects and overall representation? Fatuma Mohamed of Migori County topped at 73.2%, followed by Doris Buridonya of Kisii County at 70.8%. At number three was Ruth Odinga of Kisumu County at 66.7%. There was Christina Ombaka, Siaya County, 61.5%. Then Joyce Bensuda, Homa Bay County, 58.6%. And lastly, Jerusha Mumanyi, Nyamira County, at 52%. The next one, the AMPs, on the AMPs approval. And the question was, are you aware of your AMPs ongoing development projects and national representation? If yes, do you approve? At number one was Otiende Amolo of Rarieda constituency, at 81.4%. I think he's the highly rated elected leader in Nyanza. At number two was Anthony Kibagendi, Kitutu Chache South, at 80.8%, followed by Mili Mabona, Suba North, at 78.1%. There was Opia Wandai Ugunja, 75.6%, and Peter Kaluma, Umabei Town, top five, 74.2%. At number six was the majority chief whip, Silvanus Osoro of South Mogirango, 72%. Then Paula Buor of Rongo at 70.8%. There was David Ochien, Ugenya, at number eight at 69.2%. Then Mark Nyamita of Uriri, 67.7%. And to close the top 10 was Obadia Barongo of Bomachoge Borabu at 65.9%. We also included, unlike the Mount Kenya, we didn't include those in the middle. But in our case, we also considered, we basically ranked all of them. So this is from number 11 to number 32. I won't go through the whole list, But at number 11 is Samatandi of Alego Songa. And then there is Rosa Buyu, Kisumu West, Seme James Nikal. There is Eve Obara, Kakondo Kasipul. At number 21, there is Junet Mohammed, Suna East. There is Suba South, Karoli Omondi, number 26. Then at number 32 is Nyando, Jared Okelo. Now for the bottom 10, the question, the same question was asked. And at number 33, Daniel Manduku, Wanyaribari Masaba, 42.5%. There is Ong'ondo Were, Kasipul, at number 34 with 41%. Then Onyango Koyo, Zari Janda, there's Martin Owino, Elisha Odhiambo of Game, there's Walter Owino of Awendo, Tom Odege Nyatiki at 36.3%, Patrick Osero Borabu 41%, and lastly was Kemero Maisori of Kuria East at 35.3%. Having done that, these were for the elected leaders. We also posed a question on key issues. And we asked, what are the current cross-cutting key issues affecting the Nyanza region? And this was a multi-choice question. And as you can see, majority say that one of the key issues affecting them is unemployment. There was the issue of accessible roads, followed by education and bursaries at 12.9%. There was the issue of health services at 12.1%. We need to remember that this survey was collected when the current ongoing strike in the health sector. There was electricity connection at 8.5%. Market for produce, 8.1%. Security, 6.9%. Farm input, 6.3%. Access to water and others. And just to note, Nyanza is mostly a rural, has rural counties, but we also have urban areas and towns, and you find that unemployment was recorded as a key issue, mostly in Kisii and Kisumu. And then you find the issue of accessible roads was mostly in the southern part of Homa Bay and Migori. So some of these issues, some are very specific to specific areas, but issues of education and bursaries was cross-cutting and health. We also have a breakdown county we can share with any media that is interested with the full key issues of the region. After this, we asked the question, a bit of a political question. And the question was on issue of Nyanza leadership. And the question was, considering the Right Honorable Raila Odinga interest in the African Union Commission chairperson position, what do you think he should do in relation to local Nyanza leadership politics? And this is a question that we added because it was a question that was most of the respondents, they were wondering what next, what next. So we decided as COG to put the question to the people. And as you can see, 41.6% say that even if Honorable Raila Odinga joins AU, they still consider him to be the leader of the region. And there is undecided and no response. We had the highest rate of non-responsive respondents on this at 31%. Then there is 27.4%, which is a significant amount, that says that in case he ascends to AU, he should retire from local politics. Which brings us to the next question. We post, and this one we break it into two, because Nyanza has predominantly two ethnic groups. So on the four counties, which is Siaya, Kisumu, Homa Bay, and Migori, we ask the question, considering the above, i.e. if Honorable Raila is to retire from local politics, whom will you pick as the emerging Luo leader and possible successor? And 51.8% says Honorable Babu Owino, who is the Mbakasi East MP, they consider him as the possible successor and the emerging Luo leaders. There was a surprise entrant, Governor Gladys Wanga, at 11.6%. Her name has not been public on the issue of Luo leadership, but she emerged second. Then there was John Mbadi, the ODM chair, at 10.3%. There is the Ugunja MP, Opiyo Wandayi, at 9.8%. Then there is the PS, Raymond Omolo. Also, some of the respondents consider that he's an emerging Luo leader and a possible successor. There is others, and anybody who didn't score above 5% was placed into others, the 11.3%. But just to mention, others, some of the name in others, there was Miguna, there was Owalo, there is Kidero. Three of some of those who are mentioned that they could possibly emerge as Luo leaders, but they didn't get more than 5% from the respondent. We also posed a similar question in Nyamira and Kisii County. And the question was, considering the above again, whom will you pick as the emerging Gusii leader and possible successor? And an overwhelming 67.4% said Kisii Governor Simba Arati is the emerging Gusii leader. The 10.8% said the majority chief whip, Silvanus Osoro. There was, again, a surprise entrant, Honorable Anthony Kibagendi, the Kitutu Chache South MP, at 6.5%. Then there were others that were mentioned that didn't poll more than 5%. Among the others were, of course, Onyonka was mentioned. There's the former CS, Matiangi, was mentioned, among others. So that was our survey. And just on demographics, on who, where did we collect it and from who, the age breakdown was, we tried as much as possible to make sure that the youth bracket doesn't answer most of the question. So youth are 36.9%, there is 36 to 55% at 33.5%, and above 55 years, 29.6%. The gender breakdown, as mentioned earlier, was 52.4% and 47.6%. On education, again, no formal education was 12.5%. Those who say that they reached primary level, 20.8%. Secondary level, 36.8%. And those who in college, graduates, postgraduate, 29.9%. On economic activity of the respondent, 9.2% were students. And these, for economic activity, you can be both. You don't have to be one. Yeah, some ticked several. The farmers, 21.3%. Casual laborer, 23.7%. Self-employed at 16.8%. Formal employment, 15%. And the unemployed, 13.9%. So with that, gentlemen, concludes our State of Nyanza survey for today. And in the next coming weeks, we're already collecting data from Western and Coast. Upon their release, we also invite you. Then we move to other regions. Then we'll finish with Nairobi. Thank you very much for coming. Thank you.
Thank you.
In case of any question, as they record. Yeah, I'm going to WhatsApp or email, which one you prefer. I'm going to send it to you. Thanks.